हेलो फ्रेंड्स, सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल टू गेट लेटेस्ट वीडियो अपडेट एंड टैप द लाइक बटन। बेंजोइन कंडेंसेशन रिएक्शन टेक्स प्लेस इन एरोमेटिक एल्डिहाइड। व्हेन टू मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ एरोमेटिक एल्डिहाइड रिएक्ट इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ साइनाइड आयन डिसॉल्व इन अल्कोहल वाटर सॉल्यूशन व्हिच लीड्स टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ कंडेंस्ड प्रोडक्ट कॉल्ड एज अल्फा हाइड्रोक्सी कीटोन। Here you can see the reaction when two molecule of benzaldehyde, they are reacting in the presence of potassium cyanide, water and ethanol, benzoin is obtained as a final product. This method is suitable for the conversion of aromatic aldehyde. Here you can see this aldehyde group is converted into alcoholic group. So that is why this product is called as alpha hydroxy ketone. Because two functional groups are there, so it means if carbonyl carbon is there and two functional group, that compound will become ketone. And because of presence of hydroxy group on alpha carbon, the end product is alpha hydroxy ketone. Benzoin condensation is a suitable method for the conversion of aromatic aldehyde, and cyanide ion act as a catalyst. Cyanide ion is a strong nucleophile which act as a good leaving group. Benzoin condensation reaction proceed by nucleophilic substitution reaction followed by the rearrangement reaction. Let's start with the reaction mechanism of benzoin condensation. In first step, you can see the cyanide ion goes under nucleophilic addition reaction to the carbon to create cyanohydrin effect. So here cyanide ion is generated from the potassium cyanide. KCN will split into K plus and CN minus. This cyanide ion will go for nucleophilic substitution on this carbonyl carbon. So this CN will form a bond with this carbon, and the double bond between carbon and oxygen will break, and oxygen will get negative charge. So here you can see the CN undergoes nucleophilic substitution on this carbon, and oxygen will get a negative charge, which is indicated by the red color. Again, this structure is in equilibrium with this carbon ion structure. Here you can see the reshuffling of proton takes place in this structure. The hydrogen which is present on the carbon will reshuffle, or rearrangement reaction will takes place, and it will go on the oxygen, and the OH group will form here. So both these structure are in equilibrium. So this is the carbon ion. Carbon ion means the compound in which the carbon have negative charge. So here in the first step, the carbon ion formation takes place. Let's move to second step. In this, carbon ion is resonance stabilized. So here you can see the negative charge will come between these two carbon, and there is a double bond formation takes place in the structure, and the triple bond which is present between the carbon and the nitrogen in cyanide will convert into double bond. So here you can see again the rearrangement of electron takes place in this structure. The negative charge will form a bond between these two carbon, and it will convert into double bond, and the triple bond between present between carbon and the nitrogen will break, and nitrogen will acquire the negative charge. Now step 3, the carbon ion attacks a second molecule of benzaldehyde. So here you can see this is the carbon ion structure, and this is the second molecule of benzaldehyde. So this carbon with negative charge will form a bond with this carbonyl carbon, and again the double bond present between carbon and oxygen will break, and oxygen will get a negative charge. So here you can see this is the structure. In step 4th, the alkoxide ion which was formed in step 3 will remove a proton from the hydroxide group. So here you can see the OH group is there. From this OH group, the proton will reshuffle on this oxygen with negative charge. So here you can see the structure. This oxygen gets negative charge, and this negative charge oxygen will get hydrogen. Step 5th, formation of benzoin product. So again there is a rearrangement of electrons, and this oxygen negative charge will have extra pair of electron that will move to the bond between carbon and oxygen and they will convert into double bond. So this negative charge oxygen will form a double bond with this carbon and it will convert into carbonyl carbon. And because the double bond is formed and carbon have four valency, this cyanide ion will be liberated. So this is our benzoin product. In this, oxygen with negative charge is converted into double bond carbonyl carbon and this OH group will remain as such. So this became our benzoin product and the cyanide ion is liberated from this structure. Perkin reaction is also called as Perkin condensation reaction. This reaction is developed by William Henry Perkin. This reaction is generally used for the synthesis of cinnamic acid. It is a type of aldol condensation in which aromatic aldehyde react with acetic anhydride in the presence of alkali salt of the acid, which act as a base to obtain alpha beta unsaturated aromatic acid as a product. Here we can use other type of bases also. This is the general reaction of Perkin condensation reaction. This is aromatic aldehyde, this is acid anhydride, and this is the alkali of acid. And on hydrolysis, the alpha beta unsaturated aromatic acid is obtained. Let's start with mechanism. In step first, the acetate ion abstract proton from the alpha carbon of anhydride producing carbon ion. So here you can see acid anhydride and the acetate ion. You can see this is the sodium salt of acetic acid which splits into Na plus and CH3CO minus mean acetate ion. So this acetate ion takes proton from acid anhydride and convert into acetic acid and there is a generation of carbon ion. Here you can see the proton from this CH3 group is taken and the bond between carbon and hydrogen will break. Proton is liberated and this carbon will get a negative charge. So it is converted into carbon ion. In second step, this carbon ion which was formed in the previous step will attack the another molecule of aromatic aldehyde. This pH represent the phenyl or the benzene structure. Here you can see aromatic ring is phenyl or the benzene structure. So this is the another molecule of aromatic aldehyde and this is the carbon ion. This is the carbon which has negative charge. So this will form a bond with this carbonyl carbon and the double bond will break and oxygen will get a negative charge. So this type of structure will form. Here you can see pH is there, oxygen double bond is broken and oxygen will get negative charge. This hydrogen will shift at this position and this CH2 will form a bond with this carbonyl carbon. So this is the CH2, then C double bond O, O, C double bond O, CH3. So this structure will form in second step. Let's see the third step. In the third step, addition of proton to alkoxide ion by the hydronium ion. So alkoxide ion which was formed in the previous step react with H3O plus. H3O plus is highly unstable. It can easily liberate the proton. So this H3O is converted into H2O and one of the proton will go to the oxygen with negative charge. So this oxygen with negative charge will convert into hydroxy group. So this is the step third, addition of proton to alkoxide ion. In step fourth, dehydration takes place. This carbon will have hydroxy group and the neighboring carbon will have hydrogen. So on heating at 170 to 180 degree centigrade, this OH and H, they will form a water molecule and they will leave this compound and double bond formation will take place. So here you can see the OH and H will leave in the form of H2O and the double bond formation will take place. Step 5th is the hydration process, in which introduction of water molecule takes place. This structure and the water, they will split into two portions. You can see H will go to this side, we see double bond O, and OH will go to this side. So both the structure will split into two half. H will form COH group, cinnamic acid, and this OH with C double bond O, CH3, will form acetic acid. This is the product of Perkin condensation reaction, cinnamic acid and acetic acid.